So good morning once again to all of you. Let me start my lecture today. So beta, we are doing revision for chapter 5. Okay, cloud computing. So what is the need of cloud computing? What is cloud computing? These things are very important to know. So before I start my topic, I would like to give a little introduction about it and little bit near about things about it. Okay, so when we need to have a office, means let us say I want to open up my IT company, and for that I need a office space, and I will also be in need of hardware, like computers I will be needing on. Softwares are also required. I will also need few servers to set up, right? And then I would need the electricity, and the cooling system is also required. IT experts are also required to manage the infrastructure. So this all will be a great expense for my capital, right? So if I don't have so much of money with me, then what can I do? Either I can drop my idea to set up a IT company, or what I can do, I can take help of cloud computing. Okay, to overcome all these headaches of these expenses, what I can do, I can go with the cloud computing. So if I am using the service of the cloud computing providers, the cloud service providers, then I don't have to purchase all these things, and I'll be just paying them for whatever services I am in need of, right? So when I'm hiring them for doing my job, obviously I need to pay something to them, right? So in order to pay, I need to first register myself to these service providers, then only I'll be able to use their services. Okay, and how to register? We need to go to that particular website of the cloud service providers, and after going to that particular website, we need to create login ID and password there. Then our account will be activated that moment only, and the services that they are offering to us will be shown, and we can select any of the service and can go with it further after paying it. Okay, so now along with the book we have to go. So what is cloud computing? Cloud computing is a technology that provides resources and services over the internet. Okay, so it's a technology that is providing resources and services. What do you mean by resources and what do you mean by services? Resources like email, schedules, music, photos, videos, games, websites, programs, web apps, servers, storage. Means what? If you want any of these resources, like you want to upload your photos, like you want to upload your videos, like you want to play the games, you want to create website. Okay, you want to play music. Okay, you want to send email messages to your friends. So these all are the resources. So if you want these resources with you, for that you need to pay something, or it can be free of cost also. So it depends totally upon the organization, or we can say the cloud service provider, that whether that organization is keeping that service free or paid. Like Google Chrome, I mean Google is providing us a Google Drive service that is there to store the data. Means 15 GB they are providing you free of cost there. That 15 GB that you can use for storing anything. You can store your audios, videos, games, websites, means whatever storage actually you want to do. You want to store your music files, you want to store your photos, you want to store your videos, or any software you want to store in that space. So whatever storage you want to do in that 15 GB, you can. So that 15 GB is free of cost. So we can use it without paying anything. Okay, but if we want to go beyond 15 GB, then we should pay for it. Okay, it's like 130 rupees or 135 rupees per month they will be charging. So it is totally dependent upon that cloud service storage provider, that whether it wants to give the service free of cost or for paid. Okay, so what other services you can have. You can access softwares online, like Google Docs is a very good software, as we have our Microsoft Office. Okay, so the Microsoft Office, actually it is a paid software, but if you are using without paying, that means you are using a pirated software. But if you want to work with a genuine software and we don't want to buy it, then we should go with cloud computing services like Google Docs. So it is free of cost. Okay, so you don't have to pay anything for it, and moreover, that software is available online. So when you have something available online, that is really very beneficial. How it can be beneficial? Because you are able to access that service anywhere throughout your world. Okay, means you are not supposed to be at a particular place at home to access this because it is present at your home. No, you can go anywhere and just you need to log in. Okay, you need to enter your login ID and password, and definitely it will be accessible there at any location you can access them. So you can access the resources also, you can access the services. Services include your softwares or your online storage. Okay, so resources plus services are a part of cloud computing. So cloud computing is a technology that provides resources plus services. So what are the resources? Like you can upload or use music files, like Gaana app is there that is offering online free songs to you, right? Photos you can upload in Google Photos, also you can upload your photos. Videos you can upload, you can use online games that are available, websites you can create. So many resources are there and many services are there, means you can use many softwares, you can access many softwares online, and you can store your files online. Okay, so I hope the cloud computing definition is clear. It is a technology that provides resources and services, and resources include email messages, schedules, music, photos, videos, games, website programs, web apps, servers, storage, and many more. And services includes access to the software or the online storage files. Okay, so now it is totally dependent upon the service provider whether he is giving you the free service or the paid service. Okay, so you have to go along with that only if you want to take service of from that particular cloud service provider. Okay, so why people are going with cloud storage, cloud computing, or we can say, so there are many reasons why they are selecting the cloud computing. So first is your accessibility. What is accessibility? Means you can access the softwares or the resources throughout the world anywhere. For that, you just need to have a device that is allowing you to access that particular thing, and an internet connection. Good speed internet connection is required. Means if you are having internet on your laptop or your mobile phone, so definitely you will be having access to all those facilities that are being provided by cloud computing. Okay, next is cost saving. I don't have to purchase any software or hardware. You just need to have a good internet connection and the device that supports the cloud computing services. That's it only. Otherwise, everything you can have on rent. Means you can pay for that and you can use it. Okay, so you don't have to buy hardware or softwares. Means you don't, if you want to use, hardware, like any hardware like you want to use that is available online, or software also that is available online, so you don't have to purchase. Like you want to use a particular software that is paid, okay, like many softwares of different organizations, they are paid, but you want to use them, so you need to pay. See, if you will buy them, they are costly. Like we are talking about Microsoft Windows. So if you are purchasing, it is more than 10,000 rupees. Okay, so if you want to use the genuine window and you don't want to purchase it, then you can have it on, from the cloud computing. So definitely they will charge you monthly. Means it can be anything in hundreds, like 200, 400 per month, like that. It can be available very easily online. So by paying 200, 400, if you are using a genuine product, which you actually needed, though that is quite cheap instead of paying more than 10,000, right? So cost saving. Okay, next is space saving. If you are purchasing the laptops and other things, so definitely you need to arrange space for them also. But if you are directly using them, using the power of these things, and you are not purchasing them, definitely you don't have to manage for the space of these things. Okay, next is scalability. Like we have taken example of Flipkart or Amazon also. If they are hiring a sale on 15 August or any particular festival, so they need more servers to handle the number of people that are using their facility or the sales that they are offering. So in order to increase for a temporary basis, they should not purchase servers because they will cost them much more. So what they can do, they can hire them on rent through their cloud service provider. Like sale will go for hardly 1 week or so, right? So if more than that it is not required, these things are not required, then what is the need of blocking the money for these things? Okay, so what we can do, we can use the cloud computing for increasing or decreasing the computing requirements as per our needs. Okay, so what four benefits I'm telling you means actually these are the reasons why the people are selecting or going with the cloud computing. One is accessibility, second is the cost saving, third is the space saving, and fourth is the scalability. Means when you need something, you can hire it, and when you are not in need of something, you can drop it. Like you want to go somewhere on a car, but you don't have car. Okay, so what you will do? You will purchase a car, or you may hire it on rent for that day. So what is the best option? The second option, obviously, right? You want to live in Mumbai for one week or 1 month, I must say. So what you will do, you don't have any house there. What you will do, you will buy a house there, or you will have it on rent, or you may live in a hotel. Okay, so instead of buying all these, which are temporarily required, we can go with the renting option. So for a particular duration of time, for which we need these services, we can have it on that particular duration for rent, right? So for whom we should contact to get these services? The cloud service organization or cloud service providers, we can see. So what advantages the cloud computing is offering you? It is the most efficient, I mean cost efficient, and it is very easy to maintain and upgrade. Upgrade means if you want to make changes into it as the technology is changing. So you don't have to think over it. If you want any updated version, you just tell them, I just want this version. They will arrange it for you. You will not be in any trouble that how to manage the updated version of it. It is their headache, they will manage it. Okay, so it is very cost efficient. So next is you will get the large storage capacity, as I am telling you example of Google Drive that is offering you free storage space. Similarly, many other, you know, websites are there or cloud service providers are there that are offering you free storage space. Okay, so that space can be used for any purpose, anything that you want to store there, you can. Okay, next is it can allow access on the internet. So you can access the files on internet, like you are creating your document on the Google Docs. So you can access those documents very easily on the internet. Okay, you just need to create an account, get the login ID and password, and definitely you will be able to access these things on the internet. Okay, so next is means you can watch a video, you can add photos, whatever files you have dropped in your Google Drive or any other feature that you are using, so you can use it from there. There is no issue. Backup is very easier and less expensive because you don't have to pay your attention to keep a backup. Okay, so backup can be taken up very easily, and who will be managing this backup? The backup will be managed by the person who is handling the cloud service. Okay, so they will create multiple copies of the backup, and they will just charge you. They will not ask you, we are purchasing this these many hard disk for storing your data, so pay for the hard disk. They will not say you. They will just say you to pay for on monthly basis to manage your data. Okay, so buying hard disk is very costly. Instead, be paying them for managing of your data is very cheap actually. Okay, doctors are also using this means this feature to share their means the things that relate they are related to related to the patients. Okay, now updated versions of the softwares, they are providing you updated version of the software like Google Docs you are using, and I am also using Google Docs. The same version will be provided to us both. Why? Because online one single version will be available to all the users that who are using that particular software. Let us say if you have a Microsoft Office 2010 at your home, but I am using Microsoft Office 2019. So if I send you some file in Microsoft Office 2010, you might not be able to open it properly because you are using a older version. So there can be compatibility issues in the versions of the software. But if we are using a particular software online, so you all, means we all will be using the same version that is available online. So there will not be any compatibility issues. Okay. Next is the service providers. So who all are the service providers? Service providers, actually, they are the organizations that are providing you services to use the internet technology, and they can charge you for it or they may provide the service free of cost. Okay, so who all are the organization that are providing these services? These are Amazon Web Service, Google Cloud Platform, and Microsoft Azure. There are many others also, many other organization also that are providing the services to us. For that, we need to create an account, login account, and password we need to set, and we can use the services. Like Flickr.com allows you to upload your images on the Flickr server that you can access online anywhere throughout the world, right? Google Docs is another software that we can use to create our documents online. We have seen this in our practical sessions also. Google Drive is also one of the service of the Google that helps you to store the data online. Means you can work online anytime you can work, right? So these are the services that the cloud is offering. So you must learn the examples of this cloud service providers. Okay, now the characteristics of the cloud computing. What are the characteristics of cloud computing? For that, I told you, just need to create an account, okay, login account. You need to enter your username and a password, then easily you can use the power of the cloud computing. Fine. Next is the characteristics of the cloud computing. So first is on-demand self-service. When you want the service, you will get it. Means there is no problem that when the IT experts will be available, then only you will be able to use it. No, you can use these services anywhere, anytime. You are not in need of any IT expert to manage your resources. Everything will be done by them on time. Okay, and you just need to go to the portal and register yourself. Services will be in front of you, and you yourself can decide which service you need, and you need to pay for it, and that service will be available. So they are self-service portals. Self-service means you don't have to wait for anybody to help you out. You can get the service yourself on the portals they have designed. Okay, no human interaction is required. So no wastage of time. Now it is night, the team is not available, so we can't get the service. You will definitely get at night also. 24/7 the portal is open and you can avail those services from there. Okay, next is elasticity. Elasticity means that you can increase or decrease the requirements according to your convenience, or I can say you can upgrade or degrade as per your requirement. Okay, so like Diwali sale is there, so many of the websites, they will need more servers to handle the needs of the customers. So I can say when Diwali sale is there, there is a lot of traffic on the websites, Okay, so traffic means by using this word traffic, I doesn't mean that vehicles are there. I just want to say when we say traffic on the website, it means number of people that are accessing that website. Okay, so when Diwali sales come, so the traffic on the website is increased. Why? Because they are offering lot of things on their websites. The websites, they are offering different things at a lesser price, so traffic is increased. So when traffic is more, definitely the more servers are required to handle that traffic. Okay, so what we need to do, we need to purchase, we can purchase more servers, but that will be a blockage of larger investment. Why? Because that when this that sale will get over, the means the traffic will automatically get decreased. So what we will do with those servers that we have purchased? So instead of purchasing those, what we can do, we can use the power of cloud computing. So when we hire, means when we have requirement for that particular server, we can pay them and they will give us the facility of additional servers for a particular duration of time. Okay, and after that they will take that facility back. Okay, pay per use means what? Means the resources that are available to you can easily be used according to you have paid. Okay, if you want storage space 20 GB, so what they will do, they will definitely show you, means they will definitely charge you. Okay, so what you need to focus on, what facility you need, and whatever facility you need, according to that you need to pay them. After that, that service will be available for you, right? Now, resource pooling. What is resource pooling? Like, you people want to go together in a car, so what you are doing, you are pooling. Okay, so when we want a particular service to be used by a group of consumers, okay, in that case we can go with the resource pooling. Okay, so resource pooling actually allows few or multiple cloud customers to share something, so that everyone will be that part and will be used by all of the members who are the part of that particular cloud. So you know, there are three types of cloud, actually four: private cloud, public cloud, hybrid cloud, and community cloud. So when we are working on a cloud, though there are many types of customers or consumers that are using that particular cloud. So if that cloud we have and we want to use the services that are available on the cloud, so definitely we are pooling. Like, our school is having a private cloud, and that cloud is offering us the assessed app, and the members, whosoever is a part of that organization, will be using that assessed service for this from any of the location. Okay, at any time they will be using. So this resource pooling means when multiple users, they are using the cloud service. So definitely it saves money. If only one person is using that service, so it will be costly. But if we are using the service for many of the consumers, so it will be a cheap option for us, right? So resource pooling is basically related to sharing of the things that are available on the cloud. Okay, and you can use, multiple users can use them at the same time or at different timings also, from the same location or from different locations also, right? Now, the types of cloud. So private cloud we have just discussed, that is owned by an organization. Okay, like our school is hosting assessed site, so that is a private cloud, and the service, the software they are using is available for all of the students that are a part of the organization. But those who are not a part of organization, those who belong to outside world, will not be able to access those services that are present on the private cloud. Okay, so only the students of the school will be able to use this private cloud. Okay, or a particular the members of a particular organization will be able to use the private cloud. Next is your public cloud. The public cloud is a cloud or the online facility that is available for other than those who are, means not a part of an organization. Actually, it is beyond an organization, so any of the member can use it by creating an account. So these services are available for everyone. It is not owned by any of the organization. Any individual can use it. Okay, so for that, just create an account and you can use the facilities. Like you want to use, you want to upload a video on YouTube. So definitely you need to create an account and you can upload your videos very easily. So that is a good example of public cloud. Hybrid cloud is a mixture of, or we can say the combination of private plus public. Okay, so we have discussed what is private cloud and public cloud. There are many other differences also in the private and public cloud. Let me discuss these differences also. So private cloud actually is owned by an organization. This is not owned by any organization. And if we talk about the security, so private cloud will offer us much more security than the public cloud. Okay, if you want to customize, in which cloud you can customize? You can customize your requirements with the private cloud. Okay, so if private cloud is available, definitely you can tell them, I want this type of service, they will manage it for you. But on YouTube, if you say, I want this type of things, so definitely YouTube will not manage it according to your convenience. Okay, so security is more in private, less in public. And the next thing is ki customization is possible in your private cloud, not in your public cloud. Okay, next is your hybrid cloud, which is a combination of private plus public, means something will be kept private for few and many of the things will be kept public for others, right? So combination of private plus public. Next is your community cloud. So when a group of organizations which are having common interests, they are clubbed together to use a particular cloud. So such clouds are known as community clouds. Okay, so group of organization or community which are having common interest and they are using a particular service that is being offered, that particular cloud is known as community cloud. Next is your services of the cloud computing. Just the principle of the cloud computing is pay as you go. And we can say a question can be there, which model upon this cloud computing works on? The model is pay as you go. So pay as you go tells you, as you will pay, you will get the services, right? So if you will pay for, you know, uploading of the things, then you will be given that service. If you are paying for accessing of software, you will be able to access the software. So as you will pay, you will get the service. Okay, now there are different types of services. One is your infrastructure as service, second is your software as service, and third is your platform as service. Okay, so let us discuss these services one by one. So firstly, we'll go with this software as service. So what do you mean by software as service? Software as service, actually, it is a method where we are using the software applications that are available on internet. Like you want to buy food. Okay, for that there are many apps that are available. So what you will do, you will download that apps and you will order the food that is available in that particular software. Like they are offering you to buy a burger or anything else, like kuch bhi that you want, but that should be available on that particular site or that software. If that particular software is not offering you that particular food, then you cannot buy it. You want to eat chow mein, but that is not available on that software, that then you cannot make any modifications in the software that I want to have chow mein, but that is not available, so you cannot order that. So you can just use that software. Okay, you cannot make changes in it. Okay, you can download and you can use it through your phones, tablets or PCs. Okay, so software as service. So you will be downloading the software and whatever facilities that software is of giving you, you need to use that only. You cannot do anything else. Like you don't have to be worried about how the product will be delivered to me, who will come, at what time he will come to deliver me the food, right? So you are not concerned about these things. You can just tell them whatever is given in option in that software. Okay, other than that, they will not be interested in listening to you. Okay, so just software usage is allowed. Okay, so we are generally using software as service. But what if you become a developer and you start creating your own apps, aap banane lag jate hain apps, and you want to create a website or you want to test or create a program, that time if you become a developer, means you are acting like a developer and you want to create, test, run and run apps or the softwares, and you want to create websites. So you can use the service platform as service. So when online you are creating all these things, so definitely you are using platform as service. So that time you will hire hardwares or softwares to create, test or run these apps or websites. Okay, so software as service, platform as service is done. Now we will take example of infrastructure as service. See, sabse lowest we can say the facility that is given in the form of software as service, then platform as service, and the maximum services are provided at this level, infrastructure as service. Here only we can use the software, here we can create the software, here we can create softwares as well as we can use any other option also, like we can store the things also, we can increase the processing power of the CPU also. Like I am using a particular software and I want the upgraded version of it free of cost. Actually not free of cost, for that I'll be paying, but I don't want to purchase it. So I'll pay them, the cloud service providers, I'll pay them and they will give me the updated version of that particular software. I don't have much space to save things at my laptop, but if I want to scale up my storage capacity, then I will go with the cloud storage. They will provide me the enough space that I am in need of. Okay, so I can hire servers also, I can increase the CPU capability also, I can increase the bandwidth of the network also. So I just need to tell them, like shopping season, when comes the holiday shopping season, like when sales they are offering us, the Amazon and the Flipkart websites and many other websites, what they are doing, they are scaling up their processing power, they are scaling up their storage, and they're scaling up their servers just by using this facility, infrastructure as service. Okay, so infrastructure as service is the highest service that we can have from the cloud storage providers. So we have read software as a service, platform as a service, and infrastructure as the service. Okay.